Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. As the sun sets over the waves, vast numbers of animals begin to rise from the depths of the ocean towards the surface. Creatures that had sought refuge from predators during the day, but now, under the cover of darkness, they gather near the surface to feed on the abundant food. Driven by a number of processes, these deep-sea migrations unite planktonic organisms and their predators in a constant cycle of movement. Let's take a look at some of the deep sea's unique migrating animals and uncover their incredible adaptations to a wandering lifestyle. It is a necessity for creatures of the pelagic zone to become nomadic. Spending their entire lives in the expanse of the open ocean, they must learn to use the currents and cycles to their advantage. Thus, many have become migratory, adopting certain routes and behaviours in order to follow prey, find partners, or seek out secluded shallows to raise their young. But most animals of the midnight zone, living below 1,000 meters, spend their lives within a narrow depth range, relying on the meager resources available. This, however, is not true of mesopelagic animals from the twilight zone, between 200 and 1,000 meters deep. By living at this intermediate depth, they have an advantage. A very minimal amount of light makes its way down here, but it is enough that animals can use their incredible light sensitivity to distinguish night from day. Using this ability, a huge diversity of organisms migrate up towards the surface as night begins to fall, and migrate back down again come the dawn. A mass movement so dense that it shows up on echo sounders as a false bottom. This is a phenomenon known as Diel vertical migration, and it is the largest mass migration on the planet. As a gathering of creatures from vastly different groups, it is a vertical feast that fuels the ocean's food web. And it all relies on the smallest of marine organisms, zooplankton, which migrate vertically towards the surface at night to escape deep-sea predators, and to feed on the microscopic algae that flourish near the surface. During the day, they return to deeper waters to be sheltered from surface predators that rely more heavily on eyesight. But zooplankton and their predators are engaged in a never-ending evolutionary race, with each adapting to the behaviour of the other in order to better their chances of survival. The prey live their lives on the edge. Existence is a careful balancing act to ensure that they are neither eaten nor starved to death. Heading back to the secluded, deeper waters before dawn may mean going hungry but staying alive. A necessary compromise. For zooplankton and other prey like lanternfish, being unfed is better than being dead. And indeed, the depths are somewhat safer. Here, their adaptations of transparent or dark-coloured bodies, large eyes, and bioluminescence help them disappear into the inky darkness. At the surface, these features become a liability. But the migrations are necessary. Without them, the steady supply of marine snow, the organic material that sinks ever downwards from the shallows, would be barely enough to sustain the creatures of the mesopelagic. They there is a great deal more food available in the surface layers of the ocean, largely due to the presence of algae and microscopic plants that cannot exist in deeper water where there is no light. Phytoplankton need high light levels for efficient photosynthesis, and the zooplankton must gather at the surface to prey on them. Consequently, the entire food web of the deep sea follows, and up from the depths come the innumerable shoals of sharks, fish, squid, and all manner of peculiar creatures. Comb jellies lie in wait of passing plankton, undulating their hair-like cilia to attract prey. With teeth too big to fit in their mouths and armed with alluring bioluminescence, toothy viperfish also rise towards the surface. But among the key prey animals that adopt this daily migratory behaviour are krill. Tiny crustaceans that are a vital source of food for a wide range of predators. From fish to gigantic whales. During their migrations towards the surface, krill gather in large, dense swarms that provide a concentrated source of nutrients. Siphonophores, like the small but abundant Nonomia beyuga, follow the prey in their migration. Another creature, the Larvacean, builds a large mucus net around itself that can be over a meter wide. A deadly trap used for capturing krill. Thus, the Larvacean represents another strategy used to hunt migrators. They, like many creatures, hang motionless in the water column, in wait of the migrating shoals to pass through. The arms race between predator and prey has led to deep sea predators evolving various strategies for hunting migrators. Some active hunters chase them towards the surface. This is demonstrated by the behaviour of many aggressive predator squids, like the Humboldt squid, which hunts one of the world's most abundant deep-sea prey species. Lanternfish. Aglow with bioluminescent light, these fish are abundant enough to outweigh the entire planet's annual fisheries catch. And pursued by the gigantic predatory squid, they join the 5 billion metric tons of animals that migrate towards the surface each night. But even their predators must watch their backs. Overall, the 24-hour cycle of Diel vertical migration is one of the great forces that shapes the diversity and productivity of the oceans. Life in the deep sea would be nowhere near as diverse without this cycle. It helps to maintain the health of the Earth itself by forming a massive exchange of nutrients, oxygen, and carbon that sustains life both above and below the waves. Next time, we'll examine the transoceanic seasonal migrations undertaken by larger animals in response to changing seasons and food availability. From the infamous journey of whales to the treacherous migration of sardines. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Squarespace gives people a powerful and beautiful online platform to help create your own website. You can connect with your audience and generate revenue through gated members-only content. You can also send email communications, manage members, and leverage audience insights, all in one easy-to-use platform. Go to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch your site, go to squarespace.com/naturalworldfacts to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.